Hello friends, and welcome back to another video here on Life's Biggest Questions, the channel that looks to answer those puzzling, burning questions you want answers to. Today we'll be answering what happens to Earth's oxygen if the Amazon rainforest burns down. As always, please drop us some comments with questions you want answered, and stick around to find out if your comment from a previous video got my attention. I'll be responding to some comments at the end of this one. Make sure you hit that subscribe button and the bell so you always get notified when we post a new video. These are videos you don't want to miss out on. I'm sure you've heard by now, but the Amazon rainforest is on fire. If you don't know why or how it happened, be sure to check out some of our other videos explaining the whole incident in detail. But to summarize, what's been referred to as the world's lungs has been burning for approximately 3 weeks now because of man-made fires, encouraged by Brazil's president. Obviously, this is not only a huge issue for those living in or near the Amazon rainforest, including indigenous tribes, animals, and plants, but also the rest of the world. The Amazon rainforest is believed to be home to more than half of the world's estimated 10 million species of plants, animals, and insects, and one-fifth of the world's fresh water is in the Amazon basin, according to SaveTheAmazon.org. So for it to be completely destroyed would not only be a tragedy, but would also lead to some very severe consequences for the planet. One of those consequences is losing 20% of the world's oxygen. Now, of course, that doesn't mean there won't be enough oxygen for us to breathe. The world would find a way to adjust, and there would still be enough oxygen in the Earth's atmosphere to keep us from suffocating. But this would also mean a big increase of carbon constantly being pushed out, a lot more than we currently have, which is already a large problem and contributes to the Earth's rising temperature and climate change. It's believed the Amazon rainforest absorbs approximately 2.2 billion tons of carbon dioxide. Without the trees there to absorb the carbon and filter it out to push fresh oxygen back out to the Earth, you better believe the fight against climate change would be next to impossible. Some have gone as far as referring to the Amazon rainforest as the air conditioner of the world, with Ramulo Batista, a forest campaigner for Greenpeace in Brazil, saying that every single tree in the Amazon helps, I quote, control the humidity and how the heat is exchanging in different parts of the world, end quote. This is of course due to the amount of oxygen being pumped out every second of every day. But without that system working as it should, the world will quickly start to see and feel the effects of losing its lungs. The good news is that the Amazon rainforest is quite large. If it were considered a country, it would be considered the ninth biggest in the world, but it's already lost 20% of the land it originally had, and it's believed to be diminishing by approximately 20,000 square miles per year. And the scary part is, the Amazon rainforest works in a cycle. Its rain gets absorbed by the plants, which release water back into the air, which creates clouds and more rain. But if it keeps getting destroyed, it will make it harder and harder for the cycle to continue, which would lead to less rain. This would interfere with a cycle that is vital for the Amazon rainforest to continue functioning in filtering out carbon from the air and providing the world with fresh oxygen. As of today, it seems like we're going to be okay. Even though we've already lost a fifth of the land, it's so big that it's going to be a little while before it's all gone. With that being said, it's no secret that climate change has become more and more serious as the years have gone on. This is in direct relation with the fact that the Amazon rainforest is down 20% from when it originally started. And with the direction Brazil's president is going in, it seems like the deforestation isn't going to be slowing down anytime soon. And although the loss of the Amazon rainforest altogether wouldn't necessarily mean we'd have trouble breathing, it would definitely lead to us having issues with climate change, more so than we already do. As of today, we're already having trouble combating climate change, so if there was an increase in how quickly it's happening, there's no telling what the fate of the world would be. If you're interested in helping the cause, you can look up a handful of nonprofit organizations whose sole focus is the preservation of the Amazon rainforest. There's also petitions circulating the web for government officials to take action. As of now, it seems unclear what state the Amazon rainforest will be in whenever these fires do stop. It is important to mention, July and August are normally the beginning of the dry season and the region's driest months, with activity peaking by early September and stopping by mid-November, according to NASA. And by those standards, it seems like things are expected to get worse before they get better. Here's to hoping the Amazon rainforest, and of course, our planet, can recover from this whole situation. As always, I'd love to hear your thoughts in the comments below. When these fires stop, do you think the Amazon rainforest will be able to restore itself? How will the loss of land affect our planet in our day-to-day lives and in the bigger picture? You guys gotta let me know in the comments down below. For now, I'll be replying to some comments from the video, What If Apes Evolved Past Humans? Saeed Briscoe said, what if everyone was perfect? Well, Saeed, I will say you're perfect because your photo or display picture on YouTube is a picture of the Eagles. And I'm a huge Eagles fan. My dad's from Philadelphia, and I've always been an Eagles fan. So you're perfect, my friend. And go Eagles. The Muffin Man said, we see apes in the zoo all the time. Just imagine it the other way around. I wouldn't necessarily agree with that because zoos are kind of an enclosure. You know, these apes don't necessarily have the free rein to go wherever they want. But I get what you're saying. Just imagine it from that perspective of like the ape thinks that his enclosure is the entire world and the humans are the attraction. It'd be a very interesting movie. If I ever make it, I'll credit you. What's your real name? Is it that? I don't know. Rocky Senior One or Rocky SR1, I'm not really sure how to say this name, said, is this why I have silver hair on my back? That comment actually made me laugh out loud. For those of you guys that don't know, there is a type of gorilla called a silverback gorilla. So the joke he was making, obviously, is that because humans evolved from apes, he still has silver hairs on his back. And I think they probably just killed the joke by explaining it. And on that note, guys, I'm gonna wrap this one up. Be sure to give it a good old thumbs up if you enjoyed the video. Make sure you're subscribed so you guys never miss a video. And if you're lucky, we might actually answer one of the questions that you guys drop us in the comments down below. Be sure to share this video with a friend as well if you enjoyed it and you think they'll enjoy it. My name's Jared Bronstein. You've been watching Life's Biggest Questions, and we'll see you in the next video.